Hello, I'm trying to do an overview of the semi-eastern grid. Semi-eastern is between it's between 60 and 70 degrees. So it's just between the eastern grid at 45 degrees and the semi-western at 90 degrees. So it's just kind of an extreme eastern grid. So with this grip you can hit multiple slices, slice flat and topspin. It might be easiest to keep the spin rate the same between each side. So a flat serve, flat forehand, flat backhand, or else topspin, topspin, side spin serve, topspin forehand or topspin backhand, because the flash and the topspin techniques are subtly different, and that might be kind of confusing to get it very accurate if you're switching between the different spins. So if you do like a flat first serve and a slower flat second serve, separate them, or else do a topspin serve and a slower side spin second serve to keep the spins the same in the games. Ordinarily, this is on the forehand side, it's kind of topspin leaning because it's more closed, the racket face is more closed than an eastern. Where an Aussie grip is slightly more open, more upwards facing, whereas the semi-eastern is closer towards semi-western and western, so it's slightly more closed, and the temptation is to hit it more topspin. On the serve, it's the opposite, so a continental or an eastern serve is more slightly more closed, slightly more sideways facing on the strings, whereas a semi-eastern serve is slightly more open, so the tendency is to flatter. But needless to say, on a serve you can hit a topspin, and on the forehand it's just as possible to hit flat, pure flat shot versus a pure topspin shot. On the backhand side, it's kind of more flexible, it's easy, it's the most natural to any type of spin, so it kind of hit flat, or it kind of crossable on a higher shot, so both techniques are very flexible on the backhand side. So I'm trying to practice the serves first, or as I was saying, I'll keep the spins the same so as not to confuse myself. So I begin the session with a flat serve. I might change it towards the end, and I'll experiment with topspin technique instead, and topspin on all ground strokes with the topspin serve. I know I'm usually in a short sleeve shirt for these videos. I had a polka dot kind of shirt, but the person at the reception was saying that it's actually not all white dress code, and he was saying that I should know this because I'm from England, so I had to remind him that I'm actually from Ireland, and we don't have these strict rules in Ireland for the all white clothing. So I managed to have a vest underneath the shirt, so I'm just playing my vest, my white vest. So this is just an indoor play court in Porto in Portugal. So I begin just with a flat serve demonstration. I'll try to increase my accuracy as I go along, just take a bit of practice. Thank you. the videos each time and combine them later. So, okay. Flat serve, second attempt. Synergy and symmetry, I practice the flat shots on the other sides before returning to a serve. So I begin with a flat shot, semi-eastern grip, 60 degrees. And so backhand serve or back smash at net, same grip, same technique. Almost went in. Of course, a backhand serve is a lot more difficult than a back smash at net, because of the serve you have to get it inside the box, whereas at net you have the entire area, the entire other side of the court to hit it in. So it's a lot easier at net. Backhand flat. Backhand flat, semi-eastern. This time I'll just hit it at maximum speed and whatever happens, happens. Put in. Take the trees net again. I'm not too sure. So when you're training, it's reassuring and go in, but of course it's just all about practice. And whether they go in or out, it's really no relevance in a training session. If you lose a match in a training session, it's not too important. It's more better to try and experiment and try to learn the technique, and only when you're fully confident in your technique should you then try to be more competitive and get everything in. Otherwise it might be a bit too hasty, and you have to ensure that the fundamentals are right before you can hit them at the competitive level. Forehand top speed. So of course, if you do hit them out in a training session, you do have to focus on the technique, and so long as the technique is improving, then even if the ball doesn't go out, it's not too important. So every time I'm trying to make micro adjustments and to improve the technique. Having briefly practiced at the other sides, I return to the serve and just try a few times to to improve the serve. Flash semi-eastern.
Thank you.
charge on each side. Try to isolate the variables on the serve. So this time I'll just concentrate only on moving the wrist. Everything else will be moving slowly. Still, I won't rotate my body, and I'm just going to concentrate solely on the elbow. So, all of the tosses will be on the backhand side with a flat second eastern shot. Three maximum speed shots to finish it off. Just for contrast actually, I'll do a topspin technique on the last grip just to show you the difference between the flat and the topspin technique. Hit the racket slowly just for emphasis so you can see.